This is a quick tutorial on how to construct electric field diagrams. Electric field diagrams are vector diagrams representing charges and the magnitude and direction of the electric field surrounding them. Here are the traditional rules for constructing the diagram. First, the direction of field is away from positive charges and towards negative charges. The symbol for charge is Q. You can also color code your charges, but it is not absolutely necessary. The strength of the field is proportional to the charge. This can be represented by an increased number of lines originating from or ending at the charge. The field lines cannot cross. Otherwise, at the crossing points, the field would have multiple directions simultaneously. One way to check your work is to check both the near and far fields. If we zoom into any of the charges, then the field lines should look as if the charge was isolated. In the far field, the field should behave as if the charges were combined. In this example, the far field will only see an electric field corresponding to a charge of 2Q. Let's apply the steps and considerations for two charges, one negative 2Q, the other positive Q. What should their near field look like? For the positive charge, it has a field pointing away from it. For the negative charge, it has a near field pointing towards it. Because the magnitude of the charge is double, we increase the number of arrows to double as well. What should the far field look like? In the far field, the combination of these two charges should give a net charge of negative Q. Now for the tricky part, the rule that field lines cannot cross. This is why we start with connecting the field lines from the near fields of each of the charges to each other. After the nearest ones, we connect the next ones over. Once we run out of pairs, we connect the remaining ones to the far field in the direction we expect the far field. It is important to consider charge distributions that, while add up to zero net charge, are asymmetrically distributed. In this case, it is impossible to find a zero electric field anywhere, even though the field lines do not approach infinity. In the far field, there will always be a net electric field pointing from the positive to the negative charge, no matter how small that field is. Electric field diagrams can be applied to any number of charges.